Je m'appelle S.G. Brown, auteur de Le Destiny, La Mort et Moi, comment j'ai conjuré le sort. I come from San Francisco, California, where I have lived for the last 10 years, and I've spent most of my life in California. I worked as a waiter at a restaurant in Los Angeles, and I worked for a post-production company in Hollywood that did the marketing for all of the Disney movies, Disney and Touchstone Pictures. So I was sort of a driver and then an assistant producer. Then I moved up to Santa Cruz, got another job as a waiter so I could spend time writing, worked in an artist studio as an office manager, and then eventually moved to San Francisco. Worked in property management and then had my first novel published in 2009. This book is, in the United States, it's Breathers. And in France, I can't always get the pronunciation correct, but I believe it's Comment j'ai cuisiné, mon père, ma mère, retrouvé l'amour. Well, the real short version is that it's a story about fate and destiny and the stupid decisions humans make to screw up their lives. But it's narrated by fate, who in this book is Le Sœur, and his name is Sergio. And he is in charge of the 83% of human beings who are fated not to live up to their full potential, to screw up and make mistakes and just sort of be disappointments, where destiny gets the 17% of the people who are destined to live up to their full potential. And the way that I separate it, in the United States, we have sayings that make fate sound worse than destiny. He suffered a fate worse than death. It was a fatal disease, so these have very negative connotations. Where destiny, it's she was destined for greatness. It was her destiny. And so he is not happy with his job. It's almost like he's a government worker. He's stuck in his job and he has to do whatever comes up. And destiny loves her job because her humans are always doing what they're supposed to be doing, and again, living up to their full potential and making all the right decisions. But there's also a love story involved where Sergio falls in love with a woman who is on the path of destiny, but he doesn't know what her destiny is because that's not his job. And it's against the rules for him to get involved with women or get involved with humans. But because of falling in love with this woman, it changes the way he goes about doing his job, which leads to a lot of sort of cosmic repercussions and problems that complicate matters throughout the book. It is a bit, but I mentioned before, it's also, love also offers a bit of redemption for both of the main characters in fulfilling their own destiny or taking the path that leads them to their most optimal future. But it is, I didn't plan it for them to both have romances. It just sort of happened as it went along, and it made sense for the romance to play a big part. I started writing the dark comedy. I like laughing at things that are inappropriate and things that you might think, oh, I shouldn't be laughing at this, but it's funny, even though it's a little bit dark. So I like the dark humor. I'm a fan of movies and books that are dark humor, like Being John Malkovich and Fight Club, Eternal Sunshine of the Spotless Mind. They're all a little dark, but they all have a heart to them too. And because I have social commentary in it, I'm talking about things that are wrong with society, and a lot of times people don't want to hear about things that are wrong with society. And having the supernatural and the fantastic sort of helps me to deliver that message in a way that is a little bit lighter with the humor. And also, I grew up on supernatural and fantastic authors like Stephen King and Peter Straub. I loved watching monster movies and supernatural movies, so it's sort of part of my DNA. although I've already finished this book, Edition Agulo is publishing my most recent novel in the United States next year, and that is a social satire about pharmaceutical drugs. It's about a group of men who live in New York City, and they make their living volunteering. And I say volunteering in the United States, if you volunteer for clinical trials for pharmaceutical drugs, you actually receive payment, and lots of different types of trials. You can even do a sleep deprivation trial where you might make $10,000 in a month. So you can make some decent money, but it's always risky. But for various reasons, this is the life they've all fallen into. So they test pharmaceutical drugs. And as they've tested for so many years, they all start to develop very odd and unusual side effects that they're able to project onto other people. But they're side effects that are normally caused by pharmaceutical drugs. They're not flying or turning invisible or doing something like that. They're breaking out into rashes and suffering hallucinations and memory loss and vomiting and rapid weight gain. So it's a little bit different, but it also takes place at the same time and in the same place as Le Destiny, L'Amour et Moi, Comme J'ai Conjuré la Sœur, so there's some crossover. So it's because the new novel also deals with questions of fate and destiny.